Vanessa Stewart joins us with more on tonight's top story. Vanessa.
Marissa, we spoke to family members of bodies that were donated to Gifts for Life, and they are upset to hear the news about the recent discovery of remains found. Documents KHON2 obtained from the Department of Health shows Brian Avery, the director of Gifts for Life, had two outstanding issues. In July 2011, this letter was issued to Avery looking to collect the fines assessed for not properly filing for a death certificate for Martin Hiraga, who passed in September 2010.
To date, I still haven't received any death certificate. I haven't heard that there isn't one that in existence, but I also have no idea what the status of that request currently is.
After human remains were found by workers at Storekeeper Self Storage off Kapi'olani Thursday, family members of those who donated their bodies to Gifts for Life now have more questions than answers.
However, it does seem to be a significant health code violation and certainly potentially some sort of crime or fraudulent activity, because that was not what Brian Avery had indicated.
And this isn't the first time Avery has run into trouble. In March 2011, homicide detectives were called to Sand Island Access Road after a rental agent discovered two sets of human remains that were eventually returned to Avery. Reverend Lee Wallach, son of Maria Wallach, says he was notified by the State Department of Health after that incident.
After further investigation, they found that my mother's body was one of the bodies. That body was then taken to ultimate cremation, where we were going to have it cremated.
Wallach says about 10 months after his mother passed, he was told her body was cremated and her ashes were spread in the ocean.
We asked them to be spread into the ocean, and the ultimate cremation said that that would happen.
Sources say the remains found in the locker Thursday are those of a male and female. The city medical examiner has opened an investigation and say they are attempting to identify the remains found through dental records. Though questions still remain for Wallach and Hiraga Nushio.
Would be very interested to hear his side of the story. It seems difficult to imagine that there's any reason that this turn of events would be justifiable.
Ultimate Cremation says she has no access, or they have no access to the records, and no one was available to discuss the case. Our calls to Brian Avery were not returned. Vanessa Stewart, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.